Hi, Danica here, and in this video I'd like to share how this website is built. Now do note that the design is not from me. This was provided by the client. So in here they have the design and they're using MemberPress, and then originally they were using the Divi page builder from Elegant Themes, and then we switch to Elementor Pro for this new version, and I'm gonna explain shortly why. So this is their login page. Again, this is using MemberPress. I'm gonna log in. I need to log in as an admin in this link. So let me just do that. Okay, so now I am logged in as an admin, and if we check here, we have different kinds of custom post type and different kinds of custom post type, and we also have MemberPress installed, and we're also taking advantage of CrocoBlocks plugin, especially the form and the JetEngine. The front end, this is how it looks. Again, we're using the Elementor Pro for the page builder to achieve this design, and as you can see here, we also have some tracker going on. This is using GamiPress. We have added some custom CSS to achieve this design, but as you can see, when it is 100%, it becomes solid color, and when it is not yet 100%, then it is still a halo container or box in here with the percent of their achievement. So if I click and click away from that, automatically that's gonna close. Now this are custom post type, and this is where we have take advantage with the JetEngine functionality. So this is also a custom post type, same here, and I could slide over in here, same here. So we have different custom post type because they have different content offered. Now if I click this, as you can see, this is some strategy guide, and if I click that, it's gonna give me the post. Now, that new sign, that's actually a featured image that when assigned, it's gonna show up in there. If I go back to the dashboard, I could also go to the discount codes. And here, this is another custom post type, as you can see. And if I, this is not clickable because the aim for this page is just to show the active custom post type. Example, if I click this one, video tutorial, so there's a video, and this is from Vimeo, and we're using the 16 by 9 size. This is Elementor's video player, the default one. We haven't used add-ons for that one. And again, we have the different related items that is scrollable. Now, these buttons here, these are actually like marking things complete, and it's using GamiPress. So if I click this, as you can see, it colored this section. That means the points has been transferred, and then the points here will also change. So if we try that again, and then refresh, so it's now 100%. Now, it's not advisable to allow your members to trigger the points again and again. So there's still a missing part in this setup. So ideally, we should limit the members from completing or marking items complete. So if we visit another thing here. So example, we have some creators. So this is again a custom post type, and there is again in here a marking this item complete. And again, it colored and then it transferred the points in the vision tracker. Now, this is again GamiPress. This is GamiPress. We just added additional styling via code to make this happen, and also some script, so that when that's clicked, the color also change. But again, that is GamiPress, and this part is Elementor. before I forgot, this is also like, this is Elementor, but this is with a combination of the JetEngine's toggle menu navigation. So do note on that one. Now, if we edit my profile here, this is using MemberPress. And then this part is using the JetForm Builder. So actually, when you think it is start here. So all new members start in this step. And then when they continue, there's some questions and they need to upload their file. And then they need to set their character architect. And then some build chart and so on. And then they could join. This is like an onboarding step for these members. And then you're good to go. So whatever data the members enter, it will be shown in here. So each of the custom post type here can be marked complete. As an example that I showed you in the creators database and also in the video tutorials. This one, this is part of the header, as you can see. So they want to have some sort of announcement at the top so that when they have a new things to mention to their members, they want this to show up. And this one is also, I think, Jet Menu. Now, this website is also, we have properly like optimized this website for mobile. And as you can see, we have adjusted the design and stuff, the sizing, and even the look for some sections in mobile, because in their design, they have a very specific layout that they want to show in the smaller screen. So we need to follow that one in this project. Now, for this one, as I mentioned, originally this was using the Divi from Elegant Themes. So this is the Divi version. Divi theme is actually, it's great. I mean, I don't have a problem with Divi, but when the project becomes very, like, not complex, but has a very specific design and layout, I think that's where Elementor is very good at, because if you're gonna compare the design from here, in Elementor, this was no like brainer. We could easily create this design as long as you export the files properly. These are SVG, but in Divi, it was very tricky, as you can see. Other than, of course, if you do custom like HTML code, but we don't want that. We want to take advantage on the builder. So you could compare here how it looks from the Divi version to the Elementor. So again, Divi page builder is good, but if you have very specific design and sometimes you really just can't achieve it, but in Elementor, you can see that we have able to create and generate that design. Now, if we example compare here, creators database, and here, so this is Divi, and this is just like manually set up column per column, which is again okay. But in here, since this is using now custom post type, later on when the client decide to create a search in this page and their database becomes bigger, it will be much easier to do, because this is a custom post type now, and we could actually add a search field in this page and maybe even a filter for their database via category, terms, or whatever they need that to be. Now, if we check the Divi version in mobile, it was very challenging to achieve the example this one in Divi compared to an Elementor. Because they have this design, this is the exact layout that they want. But in Divi, it was very hard, or should I say challenging to achieve, because of how the page builder works. But again, with Elementor, we were able to do that, including the menu. They want the centered and different design for mobile. So we've also able to set that up for this client. So this is an example of a WordPress membership site using MemberPress, Elementor, GamiPress, and of course JetEngine in this new version. Again, the original one is using Divi. It's using, I think, Gravity Forms for their onboarding, which is also fine. But since we have decided to create some custom post type for the new version, we have taken advantage on the JetForm Builder. And that's what we're using in this page. So this is actually just one form with different steps. So when they continue, it's a next page and the next page and so on. So I hope this video helps and you've learned or see some example how you could create or how MemberPress membership site could look. Again, there's really no limitation here as long as you use the right combination of plugin in Page Builder. And then with that, you could create a powerful and beautiful WordPress MemberPress membership site for your programs and products.